Wearing a mask keeps you and those around you safe. So please respect the rules and respect us.
It's an upbeat message with a downbeat origin. As travel has opened back up, Aussie Airlines have reported hundreds of incidents of abusive passengers unwilling to follow COVID restrictions.
It ranges from, you know, people just being verbally abusive to staff and crew, to actual physical assaults, people actually damaging aircraft or airport property. And the message really is it's got to stop.
If you're feeling stressed or overwhelmed, remember, we're here to help you.
The No Carry-On campaign is a joint venture from Qantas, Virgin, Jetstar and Rex, who've also signed up to a code of practice to ensure a consistent response to bad behaviour.
You could be kicked off your flight, you could be banned from further flights, or you could face fines, or even potentially in serious cases, jail time. So, you know, if you do the wrong thing, you can expect to get into trouble.
But abusive behaviour isn't the only problem facing airlines. A new survey shows three quarters of us are wavering on travel plans, worried that Omicron will prompt premiers to once again shut state borders.
This will effectively be the fifth set of school holidays in a row where there has been an issue and a problem. Something like a third of businesses in the tourism sector were worried about surviving this summer holiday period and into the new year.
WA has tightened border measures, while Victoria and New South Wales have vowed to stay open. And that inconsistency is making travellers gun-shy.
I think what's really important is to think about the reasons why people are saying they're going to holiday in their own state or reluctant to travel. The first three top reasons are all to do with borders snapping shut, uncertainty, inconsistency. They're not worried about Omicron or COVID until they get to reason number four. So clearly these are things we can fix.
So with airlines copping it on all fronts, what kind of a Christmas is the travel industry in for?
Have a great flight.
Good. I mean, something about airports that brings out the worst behaviour in people just generally. Like, hats off to everybody that works at the airport, because you've got to be a special breed of person to put up with ordinary people. But you add COVID to the mix, we're the worst.
It's where you have your biggest tantrums.
Yeah, I'm always cracking it. No, but seriously, like, how the hell do you work in an airport right now?
What a stressful job. We've been travelling probably more than most in recent weeks, as that's been allowed. And I think one of the best things about it has been catching up with the cabin crew that you used to see flying previously and hearing
is that how much you travel, you are friends with the cabin crew?
Oh, you chat to them and say g'day, and like, they're pretty friendly.
Do you get free upgrades or something?
No, nothing like that.
Because you're already
maybe
at the front
of the plane. Glass of water.
Water.
But, you know, like, they've had a really tough time over these past couple of years. Some of them, you were telling me about, working at Bunnings.
Yep.
A couple of cabin crew on Qantas the other week were talking about how they'd worked in the vaccination centres when New South Wales was doing those. So my overwhelming experience with them has been that it's been lovely to see them again. They're so thrilled to be back in the skies. It's sort of, it's actually really disappointing that people have been giving them
and they love serving people. Yeah. That's why they're in the business.
Why you're in the business. But I think it's like there is a reasonable fear. I don't know what it is. People, you know, the idea of travel and airplanes, it goes hand in hand with COVID transmission. But airplanes, you'd be able to tell us a bit about the ventilation is the best on planes. Airports have incredible ventilation system. Like, it's quite difficult to catch COVID on a plane, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, at the start of the pandemic, we thought there could be nothing worse than being locked in a metal tube for 12 hours or 200 people. Mm. But turns out, because of the HEPA-grade filtration that a lot of these planes have, there's really not that much, there's not as much transmission as we would ever imagine. And I think that speaks volumes for the role of ventilation and filtration in other places, you know, in schools and offices, etc. We should be using this stuff
everywhere. I bought one online. It's like $65. It's just a little thing I have in my bedroom.
Where did you
put it? Stop with your advertising on television.
65 is cheap.
I'll give it to you for 60.